Warm rain beats down in rain. All right. Hello and welcome back to This is the Police. Last time, not much happened story-wise. Oh, except, I forgot, our deputy came up to us and said he may have found a way to actually extend our days past 180 days. Try to, like, basically stop us from retiring, or forced retirement in this case. But yeah, so that happened. We had the first 2 days that we did were pretty difficult. Hey, Dersh, how's it going? I know, right? Yeah. I went for an interview today, so that's why I'm, you know, not wearing glasses. But yeah, so I think it went well. Anywho, but yes, we, our first 2 days were actually pretty difficult. I did not have enough people to work with. And of course, City Hall, what do? They, you know, say, oh, you're not doing a good enough job. I'm going to take away more policemen from you. So, but we did make a turn. I bought maybe about 4 or 5 slots from Atticus Corp to get more police officers. And then City Hall started liking us because we started succeeding more. And so now we're starting this nice little positive snowballing effect of just having more police officers and being able to take care of bigger situations and lots more situations. So, let's continue. Alrighty. So what do we got here? We got tainted blue velvet party cookies can cause convulsions. Never heard of blue velvet. Is that a thing? Like, there's red velvet. I guess. I mean, it's just really food coloring, to be honest. Although, supposedly, red velvet, you get to a certain amount of food coloring, and then there's actually, like, a flavor to it that complements the cake. Never understood it, though. Radio station, face additional text. Okay. And study finds stray dogs more dangerous than sharks. And we're doing pretty good. We're gonna try to keep maybe 2 people open today at all times. Oh gosh, we really got a fucking drunkard. Hopefully he doesn't come in a drunk. Actually, you know what we'll do? Is, oh, did I tell him to stay at work? We might fire him today. We'll see. But if there's a better detective, I might hire one. But anyway, I want to keep my spots open because we definitely need to respond to anything Town Hall throws at us. Hey, Phantom, it's going good. It's going good. All right. Oh, and thanks for the host. All right, last year we actively fought against unregistered business activities and gray companies who shamelessly use loopholes in the law. We've tightened some rules, making it more difficult for fraudsters to rent business premises and import goods into the city, of course. They immediately became outraged and threatened to form a protest under the windows of City Hall. You must teach these parasites to respect the law. Permission to use force is granted if required. Fought against unregistered business activities and gray companies who shamelessly use loopholes. So this actually sounds like the first thing they've put in front of me that's actually worth, you know, like, forcibly removing. Most of the other ones were like, you know, rights of people. Hey, Fart Bubbler, how's it going? Yeah. we play, This is the Police from, like, 5:30 to 7, and then at 7 I start playing Morrowind. But you can hang out till then, if you'd like. But yeah, let's see. So this actually sounds legitimate. I will forcibly remove these assholes if they're using loopholes to get into, like, weird unregistered businesses. Oh, what's this? Okay. It's this Mafia, my share. I'm gonna take everything. And take everything. What was this? Small business protest. Around 80 entrepreneurs and representatives of small businesses have surrounded City Hall. Rogers is a business killer. Oh. Huh. Now, is it just. He said. Okay, now I'm wondering, like,
He said they use loopholes. I know, this game's music, right? I'm gonna do this for Town Hall. It's kinda, it kinda seems like a gray area, but I'm kinda like whatever at this point. Alright, proceed. Let's see, Jack the Mayor is acting illegally in the interest of his friends. Oh, okay, now you tell me. Which are literally destroying our community's small businesses. Okay, so he gave it a good spin to try to give me like, oh, they're like, you know, businesses that, you know, use loopholes and all that stuff. I believed him for a second, I suppose. Let's see here. So what is he saying? So many of his initiates are controversial, many of his initiates are contrary to federal law, and the police end up using force. Then you'll be the ones that take the rap. You better cover your ass if things get ugly. Huh. So he's saying I could do $30,000 to basically dump all this on Floridor. Is it louder than my voice? Really? Huh. Should I take it down? Has that been an issue in the past? I haven't been told. That's the first time I've heard it. Weird. I don't want to spend $30,000. Alright, we got a fight. Let's see here. The school principal called in a report an altercation which occurred in the school cafeteria. Hey, you fat cow, where's your udder? Yelled Miguel Marquinhos to Emma Hadzik as she passed by his table with her lunch tray. Emma blushed and then laughed out the offender. The teachers don't want to intervene. Miguel had it coming. Alright, we'll do this. We got here. We got a police impersonation. Jezebel Escalante was walking in the park earlier and saw a strange man dressed in a police uniform who was going around yelling at people. Yes, that'd be good. Yeah. Actually, I can't tell now because there's no songs. But after this, any of you like Dirge or Phantom, if you could let me know if the balance is off. I've never thought it has been in the past and nobody's brought up till now. So, well, I just want to get a confirmation on that. Alright, but let's see. He was going around yelling at people, showing them his gun and threatening everybody. Then he ran over to the dogs and rolled around in the grass. He was clearly not in his right mind and he's scaring everyone. Frankly, I don't even think he's a real cop. Alright, Austin Coing. Sounds fine to you? Alright, let me put on another song just to make sure. Alright, so you can still hear me okay and everything? Hopefully. Hopefully. So, I mean, it looks like City Hall is gonna hate us again, which is gonna suck. Alright, got the police impersonation. Seeing the police, the man walks up close and salutes. The outfit is obviously from a costume shop, but the gun looks real enough. Okay, it's good? Okay. Okay. Alright, let's see. Ooh, officer, urgently needed at the police station. I'm afraid it can't wait. Yes! Okay, it's fine, Firebubbler, but you know, always let a streamer know if you think their sound's off. That's always a good thing. Now, I think we can't do. You know what? I'm gonna. City Hall's gonna hate us a little more, but you know what? I'm gonna take the risk. I'm going to say that in the next 2 days that we do enough good that even though we failed them, it'll be fine. Alright, what do we got here? Mr. Boyd, I've been turned a blind eye to the activities of the woman's... Oh gosh, I'm not even going to report to that because it's controversial. Don't even fucking ask me. Alright, here we go. Weird sounds with me. Alright. I'm sorry, but I'm not even gonna respond to that. Holy shit. I saw the church and I saw a women's clinic. I was like, nope, not even. He only gives me like $75, so it's not even worth going to those things anyway. Aha! I can be here that day! Actually, I do want to train these people. Let's send Hunter and Huang. And what do we have here? We have a bomb threat. How many freaking bomb threats have we had? It's insane. Alright, let's get you guys trained up. And Smondi and Floridor, go ahead. There we go. So we downed a few people today, but it should be alright. How's the investigations going? Okay, good. So we got full investigations. Oh yeah, I wanted to check. Some guy came into work drunk, and I'm wondering if we might have... No, we don't have a better detective. If he does do it again, we'll definitely replace him. Alright, what do we got here? We have theft. A drug addict at the rehab center stole an expensive respirator and locked himself in the closet. The nurse tried to reason with him, but just hugged the apparatus and insisted it was his property. When the hospital employees tried to help him up, he grabbed a knife from his pocket and stabbed one in the shoulder. Alright, we'll send all you guys over. Alright, we got a... The police searched the school, and no bomb was found. A schoolgirl by the name of Lily Austin had decided to disrupt school today in hopes of avoiding a test she hadn't studied for. Jeez. Ooh, nice, Phantom. Awesome. I always feel like successfully modding Skyrim is always a great achievement. Yeah, songs wear out, man. I wish it would be on loop so I didn't have to always put in a cassette. Alright, we got a theft. Oh, I can't respond to it quite yet. Now I can. Alright, the guard of the large toy store detained a boy who he suspected of theft. I'm sure he stuffed something down his pants, but I couldn't find anything. The little thief won't stop crying. Come over quick. Alright, my theft. Wonderful. I know, right? Yeah. Jeez. Alright, drug trafficking. Ooh, I don't have enough people for this. I'm gonna have to have people come back, but let's see here. We received an anonymous tip today. Later this evening, a large shipment of heroin will arrive in the port. The cargo is well guarded, and according to a source, the drug runners won't be giving up without a fight. Okay, let's see here. SWAT, paddy wagon. I feel like this is an all or nothing mission. We'll just have to wait for Samandi and Bloomingdale to get back. Alright, theft. The boy didn't steal anything. The child's mother severely scolded the guard and took her frightened son back home. Freaking A. Small business project. Well, fuck you, Mayor! Fuck you! You scummy dirtbag asshole. Just because you like to... Who's dirtier, me or him? That's the real question, right? Assault with an offensive weapon. The bar's owner reports that his bartender was attacked by a patron. The bartender refused to serve a customer because he looked too young and wouldn't show his ID, so the guy got mad, jumped over the counter, smashed a bottle of whiskey, and now he's threatening to stab the bartender. Well, shit. Alright, and drug trafficking. Wow, that was fast. Holy shit. Nice. And we got heroin. Sell that shit. And how about now? Will two people be fine? They better be. Because that's all I'm sending. So, I think we should actually break even today with Town Hall, because we basically sent two people to do secretarial bullshit. And, yeah. So it should be even. Not responding offensively to something and that. Behind the bar is a young guy with a piece of glass in his hand. The frightened bartender is in tears. Order a drink. Whoops. Hey, Crystal Tiger. Yeah, I had to look fancy, yo. Well, shit. Unlawful assembly. Can I send him to it? No. Whoops. Apparently ordering a drink was not the right thing to do there. I thought it was one of those, like, 80s cop-like things, but I guess not. That was more... That wasn't a good thing. That's okay. Whoops. A crowd gathered in the shadow of a casino, chanting slogans recommending the prohibition of gambling in Freeburg. Gambling is a disease, or so they keep repeating. Meanwhile, the casinos hired an athletic group of young men to push back the unruly crowd. And the receiving stolen property report. Ooh, let's take a look here. Ooh, yep, yeah, we have enough frames now. All right, let's see. The mechanic. Stuart Hayes has worked on the car, washed most of his life, and learned all about using his hands. Okay, that's not much to me. Payment. Stuart pays the car thief in cash on delivery. So not on this weird orange powder, which I don't even know what that is. Oh, I just, you know, I went for an interview. I'm trying to get, like, a good weekend job, so yeah. Let's see, Stuart Hayes used little tape to mark out the space he needed to cut the car. Okay. The tool. Stuart Hayes prefers using a reciprocating saw for cutting the vehicle, so that'd be this. Let's see, and transportation. The cut-up car is distinguished as scrap metal. Loaded into a truck with a hoist and driven it into the rail station. Alright, so he uses money. Like that. There we go, nice. Stuart Hayes, car wash owner. Alright, so let's go here, I suppose. Oh, I don't have people, actually. Yeah, yeah, it's my stripper career. Mm-hmm. You live by the pole, you die by the pole. That's you know, that's a saying. Alright, let's see here. Unlawful assembly. Good. Poor guy. He wasn't professional enough. Declare dead. There's no reason to keep him around. If Floridor... Now, yeah, if Floridor died, right? I would collect his paycheck. Because his paycheck is nice and big. His would not be because he doesn't have enough professionalism and he doesn't have any honors. Alright, let's see here. So, Mayor Rogers is pleased with the police department. Fuck you, Mayor. Rogers is responsible for Freeburg break. Fuck you, Rogers. And writer Irvin Bukov presents Magnum Opus. Wow! Whoa! Holy shit! They really didn't like me doing that. Jeez, maybe I should have suppressed that thing. Freaking, I accidentally broke my bathroom mirror while I was getting ready from work. My dad said that no. No. Coming to work tomorrow. I was up all night reading. No. No, John Goodman. It's all Rogers' fault. Rogers is quite the freaking asshole. Let's go for this. Alright. It's a sad day. City Hall hates us. Alright, let's see. We can hire one more police officer. Actually, let me check this first. My sheriff of the Mafia, share with my staff, because I saw they were getting a little weird. And here's my week's salary! And what do we got? We freaking bomb threat right away, damn. Alright, some crazy man in a clown suit stopped a school bus. The driver pulled over, and he threw a grenade inside. It didn't explode, but the children are too afraid to move. Oh my gosh, we have two people with beards on the same team! It's beautiful. Actually, we should share the beard, to be honest. Cook, move to shift B. And Elizabeth Little, hire for shift A. We gotta share the beard. We can't have too much beard on one team. That's a little weird, man. That's a little too much beard than what you're used to. Let's see here. Oh, I can't do that today. Damn it. Send the cops in alone? Yeah, we don't want a lower chance of success. Okay, so I'll have to wait for that. Damn, that was fast. Let me see. Six drunks had only had a few too many and started fighting with each other. It's freaking almost 9 in the morning. Holy shit, six drunks. Fighting each other. One of the men pulled out a bottle of liquor and smashed on the pavement, then stabbed his former companion with it. The police are on the line with retiree Georgian Miller, who is watching this unfold right outside her front window. I had enough of these drunk monkeys. They are always so loud, and my favorite television program is about to start. We're fine with two people. Okay. The children are crying, but quietly sitting on a bus. The outside of the bus, there's a man in a clown suit giggling. Hey man, the joke's over, let the kids go. Nice. He was just overwhelmed. There was just too much beer. He couldn't handle it. He's like, oh gosh, I have to listen. It's just too much. Let me see here. A man accompanied by a hippie-like girl dragged a rare yellow monkey out of its cage, hid it somewhere, and then quickly left the zoo. Don't kidnap my monkeys. Don't do it. I do have... Yeah, I do have a snitch. Good. Alright, in the fight... I didn't really think of it that way, Trizadi, until you just mentioned it. And the offender was caught. I believe it's smooth jazz, however. It's not the 70s porno music. I could be wrong, though. A store employee noticed a woman who resembles the famous swindler, Lee Kuan Yew. The pictures on the TV, whose pictures on the TV many times. Alright. A swindler at a vegetable shop. Alright, beard, if it's serious. Let's overwhelm him with beards. He's got a little bit of a beard going. He needs beard training. Go with these two guys. They know, they have the beard going. Although nobody's no more beard than beard. It's just a fact. I love how we just made this thing that, like, beards are super cop, even though there is someone who has more professionalism than him. Let's see here. Amanda Clowns- What's with- There's too many bomb threats and too many people in clown suits. It's kind of weird. Amanda Clown Suit entered a bank, presented the cashier with a check for, $250 billion and demanded they cash it. He threatened the bank he would face serious consequences, if they couldn't pay him out in the entire cash and reported the head of the branch. That's kind of weird. But hey, you know, maybe it's con money. I'm not sure what the, what's the exchange rate for clown money? The place is mostly empty. The woman wearing sunglasses picks up an orange. Take a cart and put some vegetables in it and then slowly approach the suspect. The woman throws an orange at the cops, overturns some boxes, and turns the back door. Hide a banana in your pocket. Run after her. There was also throw the orange back. I love that. Some of the options they have are fantastic. Armed robbery? Shit. Alright, let's see. Five armed robbers broke into the bank and demanded access to the safety deposit boxes. The manager agreed after they shot one of the customers in the leg. During the turmoil, the security guard and five visitors were able to escape and call the police. But there are still a dozen hostages inside. Alright, that's everybody else we have. And SWAT. Now, my SWAT team is as upgraded as you can possibly get. But we'll have to see how that works out. We have to get another song. Blues for Mr. T. It's a good one. I wish you could set them on repeat or something. Fraud Report. The Man in Cloud Suit was a famous performance artist, Sigmund Hammerling. Apparently, the check was supposed to warn the public that the financial system is on the verge of collapse. Hey, Rucksack of Joy, how's it going? Alright, ooh, and what do we have here? Mr. Boyd, my vehicle transport company is regularly being attacked by bikers. They lie in wait for a lone truck out of the country and then blow the tires and steal the cargo. They put the last driver in a coma. I found out these biker gangs are at Krevin's Throat Bar after dark. I want you guys to storm in there and show them the highway to hell. And don't forget to torch their bikes, right? Holy shit. Let's fucking do it. That sounds badass. Although, how many people do I need for that? 6 people. Holy shit. Armed robbery report. Now, he pays big bucks for what he does. Ooh, civilian was killed. Ooh, whoops. But no policeman died. Now, usually these things just succeed. There's no, like, experience gain or anything like that. We have an assault. The insurance office companies are home to a fresh scandal. One of their clients accusing them of inflating her insurance premium after her husband's death in a car wash. The woman was shaking her fist as she delivered a punishing speech, then grabbed one of the agents by the tie and bounced his head off the table. Holy shit. What happened to the diversity of sexes in my squad? I literally, like, it's not even a thing for me. What I do is when I hire someone, I basically look for who's the top slot in the labor market. If it's a female, I'll, you know, it doesn't matter what gender they are, what race or whatever. It's just highest professionalism, they're in my team now. It just so happened that the random thing made it mostly male. I think my team B has a lot more females on it though, if I remember correctly. Plus, I think we're getting one more female officer for this as well. That's true, I do look for beards. That's true, I do hire beards over anything. Terrorism. Betty Sanchez told the police that she accidentally discovered some shocking entries in her husband Victor's private journal. He's planning to enter the train station and break open a large capacity storage tank filled with mercury. According to Betty, Victor hasn't been himself ever since our son died, serving in the army. I don't know this man. I'm very scared of him. Yes, Town Hall did care a while back. You're right about that. And I think, once again, I denied Town Hall because I'm tired of their PR bullshit. My police officers are, like, pretty well trained, and I'm not gonna fire anybody just to hire more of this race or this gender or whatever the fuck. Because, honestly, Mayor Rogers is an impotent fuck and doesn't deserve any of my time. Oh, I'm really pissed. I hate that man. Alright, let's see here. Yeah. Alright, and this is the assault at the tower. We may have to ignore this one, only because I don't have enough people. And I can't just- yeah, that's tomorrow. Alright, suspicious individual, Aaron Griggs, noticed a creepy man in the cemetery, during a heavy downpour. He was ignoring the rain, just walking with a purpose through a graveyard. I think he's planning to attack somebody, but then he just hurried off. I bet it comes down that he's some sort of serial killer. The thing is, now I'm pretty much going to focus on pleasing City Hall as much as I possibly can, which sucks, so I will be ignoring Atticus Corp, I suppose. Okay. And the assault. Sweet. Yeah, I got a new item in my inventory. Oh yeah, there was an update. This is the police. So now, I think I get trading cards. I got Tsubaki! I got Tsubaki as a trading card, the actual, like, Ken Tsubaki, who's on my, Shift B. Awesome. I can't respond to this right away, but let's see what's going on. Three plant workers were drinking beer on a bench and started harassing a group of young sportsmen, who were talking about, at the bar. The men started calling the athletes fags and stared at them, and then threw one of them into an empty bench. The first of the athletes were ignored by the bullies, but their patience was at an end. One of them grabbed a beer tap and broke a plant worker's head open with a single blow. The seven athletes then rallied together and started beating up the remaining men. Holy shit. Alright, that's going to take a little bit. You should be receiving a other thing soon. Homicide report. Let's open the investigation. Alright, we have enough frames. Let's take a look at this. Alright, the corpse. His right hand had been severed. There's bruises behind his knees. And there's a bullet hole in his chest and a lot of blood around the body. Hot damn. Okay, well, you know, I'd feel like that would be closer to the end, the chopping off of the hand. Let's see here. The waitress. I didn't recognize him at first, but it's my neighbor, Edgar Sanchez. I often found him with a tough, dangerous-looking woman. They're always fighting loudly. I remember she was ugly, with a tattoo of an AK-47 on her neck. Holy shit, that's a badass woman. Let me see here. Mr. Jones, homeless. I woke up to a heart-rending screams, but then I got out of my box. Everything was quiet. I only saw the man from behind. He had a gun in his belt, and he got into one of those expensive cars. He looked like a man, but he had long hair, so who's to know about his prick. There's lots of... Jeez, these dudes, man. Alright. The other day, I saw Edgar Sanchez arguing in the street with some weird guy in a hood with a cane. The guy poked Edgar in the stomach a couple of times with his cane, and I thought about calling the cops, but they shook hands and went separate ways. Sanchez always paid his rent on time in cash, though I don't think he had a job. I think he was into drugs and maybe something else illegal. That was the landlord, the medical examiner. The hand was separated from the body while Edgar Sanchez was alive. Okay, so that's more near the center. Hey, Lost Boys, how's it going? We're doing an investigation. Let's see. So he was alive when the hand was severed from him. The smooth edges of the wound indicated that it was inflicted by one swift motion. The bruises on the popliteal region were from a hard object like a nightstick or club. Apparently, the culprit forced his victim to the ground. Okay. I don't have a lot to go by. This looks like a different person. So let's say... Following... Hit in the back of the knees, hand chopped off, and then shot with a gun, and then leaving? Oh, got it. Got it. Filmon Gutierrez, small-time drug dealer. 1210. Suspicious individual report. Suspicious man was a local gravedigger who recently found a bit of extra work. There we go. And the massive fight at the workout playground. Beard Robbins. And we might be able to respond to this on time, which is pretty sweet. And SWAT just because we might need them. Sweet! We might actually be able to take this out today, which would be fantastic. Let's see what happens. Now, I did respond to everything today, so hopefully there's some sort of thing where City Hall's like, yeah, you did a good job, even though you ignored that protest. We keep ignoring protests because they're always for, like, really bad reasons. Alright, the place has turned into a real battle. More workers joined in to help their friends from the factory, and the fight expanded to involve several dozen people. Fire several shots in the air and order everybody down the ground. The fighting grinds to a halt. Two athletics approach the police The fuck you think you're doing here? We got this. We don't need you. The men look quite menacing and armed with bricks and ironwork. Taser the asshole. There we go. We'll end the day. Wonderful. Alrighty. Alright, what do we got here? Women's clinic required mayor's protection from pro-life activist. Study drunk people are more attractive. And a reclusive millionaire bequeathed fortune to city. Okay, cool. I think because we were on top of everything today, we actually did alright. We have to share a little bit more money from stuff with the mafia with our police officers. So next time we get the option, we'll do that. Everybody will quiet down a bit. I drank too much. Can't hold together. Can I go home? Sure, Marlo. Oh, thanks to the host convoy. How's it going? Alright, let's go to this one. Fuck you, gets tasered. That's exactly how it works. Mafia, my share. Alright, share 50% with staff. Make them a bit happier. And let's see. Let's go over here. Floridor and Hunter, go for it. There we go. Yeah, there's the piece of paper. Yeah. It was only until later. We had to actually meet, what the hell's the guy's name? Robespierre. We actually met Robespierre, and he's the guy informing us of all that stuff. Alright, let's see here. We got prostitution. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, convoy. Let's have a better time in here. Alright. We received an anonymous tip. A swanky mansion on the edge of town is home to a luxury brothel. According to our source, the girls there are top class, and the booze is excellent, but the prices are just astronomical. They really need to lower them a bit. I wonder if prostitution's legal here. I don't know. I think 4 would be enough to take down the prostitution ring. Hopefully. We'll have to see. And how we doing? Nice, we got him. All suspects arrested. That is weird, convoy. So now we gotta start to investigate Juan Camilo Salas. Well, I mean, when we get back with Mole. We have a mass riot. Oh, shit. Javier Forte leaves prison today, a free man. He had previously spent 15 years on death row for the murder of his girlfriend. New evidence has exonerated Forte. But for some Freeburg residents disagree with the new verdict. A crowd has gathered outside the walls of the prison and promised to give Javier a warm welcome. Prison security can barely handle the angry crowd, and the situation could easily get out of control. I won't be able to respond to that right away. We have extortion. Alright. We need a lot of people. Before the major clearance sale, a dozen bikers blocked off the entrances to the shopping center, which was crammed with people, and demanded an entrance fee. Some people paid, some people went to the other entrance, and some were so outraged they got out of their cars and started fighting. Prostitution report? Okay. And alcohol. Sell to the mafia. Alright, so... I guess, ooh, a mafia assignment. Let's see, you got something going down at the suburb at 1540. Alright, I'll ignore the thing at 1540 then. Alright, can we send, not yet, Mole's not back. Alright, I'm thinking I'm thinking we send... Let me check things out. I need SWAT and a penny bank. I have to respond to this quickly. If I don't get the paddy wagon in time, then too bad, I suppose. What the hell is this? An assault? Okay, we can take care of that too. Good. Paddy wagon? Let's see. Proceed. And then we'll have SWAT go to the thing at the prison. Four door. And then... Samandi and Austin will go to the assault. Alright, a young skinny man stormed to the pharmacy, pulled a pile of empty sports nutrition cans from his backpack, and began throwing them at the pharmacist. You sold me this useless crap. Alright, now can I do this? There we go. Whew! Damn, managing all this stuff is crazy sometimes. Oh shit, are you kidding me? And then this shit happens. Owen called in to complain about an elderly man who grabbed her on the bus. He couldn't control his drooling, and he couldn't let me go. The brute was all fingers, and the way he sits in the bus stop with his hand in his pocket, it's disgusting. Well, sorry, I won't be able to catch that pervert. The entrance is blocked by tough-looking bikers. A sizable crowd has gathered around. Holy shit, this is the mall. I don't think I want to... I mean, technically... If the bikers are stopping us, right, then we should totally arrest them. Because that's what, interference with police activity or something. I'm not sure the exact wording. I feel like this is like the asshole thing that might get them enraged, so let's arrest the bikers. Someone from the crowd begins to scream hysterically and attacks the bikers with a knife. Fire into the air and order everybody to disperse. Heck yeah. I know you're not supposed to, like... What is it called? Unsanctioned discharge or something? There's, like, a word for it. But that, like, you're not supposed to use your firearm. Obstruction of justice? Okay. Oh, obstruction of justice, yeah. I think that was auto-corrected. I got what you meant, though. Yeah, obstruction of justice. But yeah, you're not supposed to, use your firearm like that. But it's the 80s, so I figure I can. In the middle of a party at Charlotte Kiesler's house, some armed men stormed in and demanded that they arrest and hand over their jewelry and point out the safe. The security guard opened fire on the suspects. And they were treated to the garage. Holy shit. Alright, smuggling. Investigation has started. Excellent. That's for the chop shop. Okay. We'll respond to this. Probably 3 or 4 people, something like that. I don't think we need many more than that. And what's here? Attempted murder. Mrs. Cazorla saw half-naked man suffocating a young girl in a bathing suit. I assume it's like the weird playing at the beach thing, but whatevs. I sent a beard over, so we should be okay. Alright, we seem to be doing good then. I think City Hall. One more day remaining. We're on their good side for now. We've been pretty good at responding to everything. We only missed that one pervert guy. So I think we're alright. Mrs. Magant was looking through her peephole and saw her neighbor beating his daughter right there at the doorstep. He yelled, "Bullshit, I'll shove those headphones straight up your ass. Why do you always chain the door? You make me tell you every day. Why can't we just go to the house like regular people?" Let's see here. Let's see. Three security guards with guns are set up at the garage. They are preparing for the assault inside. Are formed armed robbers who have taken an elderly woman hostage. Let's tell the security guards to move in. The robbers want their freedom in exchange for the hostage. Push two more women in the garage, so the only one who's there doesn't... What?! Push two more women in the garage, so the one who's already there doesn't get bored. Wow. I love some of these options. You're surrounded, release the hostage, and come out with your hands up. Or tell them they can, go into their, they can go to their car, and when they're out in the open, move in. I always like doing it this way. Because that way they think, oh, cool, we can get away. And then they don't. Yeah. Lying to criminals. Oh, shit, sorry. I forgot about the 15. The man was giving a girlfriend artificial respiration after pulling her from the water. What? Artificial respiration? Okay. Whoops, I forgot the one at 1540. Gosh, that seems like, what, friggin' 5-6 hours ago now, jeez. Shows how long it takes for me to respond to stuff. Child abuse report. Got him. And we have a massive fight. Let's see here. During a match, some fans in the visitor's section threw a fried pig's head onto the field. Our local fans decided they'd teach them a lesson. A fight broke out, and the referee was forced to stop the match. I do not have enough people right now. Oh, now I do. If you notice, I send a lot of the, not little people, but the ones who, don't have a lot of professionalism, and then what I do is I incorporate some dudes who have higher professionalism with them. To basically train them. Because as you'll notice, like, these guys have been with me for a long time, and their professionalism's off the chain right now. Alright, we should probably get some frames, yep, for the smuggling. Usually what I do is I wait till I have enough frames to basically start putting them in order, so I'm not going to do anything right now, but I will at some point. Ooh, and what do we got? Shooting at a nightclub. Ooh, I can't send SWAT. Let's see. Someone at the club opened fire on the DJ because he refused to play a track they requested. The patrons of the club started to stampede, and a gunfight is still ongoing. Because there's no SWAT, and because it's so late... Oh, dude, yeah, Convoy, relax. Totally. Yeah, go to bed, you know, take it easy. Take it easy. It's good to see you, but... Yeah, good night, and take it easy, man. Alright, let's see here. Yeah, how do you get a fried pig head into a stadium? That's true, you're right. You're asking the important questions. Alright, so I'm gonna send everybody I got. I think it's too late to actually, like, have more things happen. Although I've been wrong before. There's the fried pig's head, holy shit. When the police showed up, many of the fans fled. A few dozen people remain in the stands fighting each other to the death. What? Take the fried pig head home with you! I would love to, like, play this game again at some point and do, like, a totally neglectful, bad choice cop. And just see where the hell that goes. Like, take all these weird-ass options and be, like, totally an awful officer. It'd be amazing. Plunge the crowd with tasers at the ready now. You don't want to plunge into the crowd. Let's surround the brawling crowd and break up the nightsticks. 311. That worked out well. All right, then we got one more thing to respond to. Shooting. And good, everybody's okay. Wonderful. Frickin' A. All right, doing good. Doing good. All right, what we got here? Dean, Chinatown dormitory overcrowded. City Hall cuts Broadenvale Asylum funding. Oh shit, I hope that doesn't come to bite us in the ass. And man in open field frightened to death by scarecrow. Yeah, it's happened a few times. Hallelujah! Alrighty. We might be able to get everything we want from City Hall, assuming that they don't do some stupid shit today. Alright, and I've always done Fire in the Brain. No, I want the other one, not Whiskey Tingle, White Russian. There we go. I need to start having more beers with this game. I enjoyed that. Although it is kind of weird, it's the middle of the week. Funeral for Maximilian Bloomingdale. You were only there for like a frickin' week, but that's okay. Oh, fuck me, an armed robbery already. A gang of masked men armed with automatic weapons enters the bank. They fired a few shots in the air and demanded the manager open the vault, while everybody else lay on, in the nervous silence on the floor. Hey, Rucksack of Joy. Oh, dude, Rucksack of Joy? Totally, totally. This game, when it was professionally reviewed, I say professionally, because literally, like, who the fuck cares what reviews are? You'll like a game or you'll not like a game. Regardless, when it was professionally evaluated by, like, you know, people who rate games, basically they said that this game has too many topical, controversial topics in it, and that's why they rated it poorly. See, the thing is, you have to understand, this game is a timepiece, right? It's 1985. It just so happens that some of the stuff in this game is actually topical nowadays. But it's trying to be old-fashioned and say, like, you have to deal with all the crazy shit they dealt with in the 80s. It just so happens that, you know, this sort of shit's coming up again nowadays, and it's just becoming a little... Oh, you know, you're dealing with a police station, so shit's gonna go down. But yeah, I mean, I'll put this in perspective. Town Hall's a little bit too racist, sexist, and care too much about PR. Definitely. I'll agree with that. But yeah, you have to understand that this game's a timepiece. It's 1985, shit's going down. You know, just accept it as a game and don't talk about it in the real world or else someone's gonna fight you. Alright, so let's see here. That should be fine. 6 people for an armed robbery. Oh yeah, I didn't read the rest, did I? Let's see. One of the guards drew his service weapon, but he didn't have the chance. The robber shot him right in the stomach. And I want everything. Otherwise, people really enjoy the game. Despite the actual, like, topics involved, people do really enjoy this game. Some people say that it gets a little bit repetitive, but for me, it doesn't. Like, everything's a little bit different, you know, there's balances of power and there's a story behind it, so I'm really enjoying it. Although they are saying that they're gonna make a sandbox mode, which will basically be like an infinite going on. I probably won't play that on stream, but hell, it's a nice thing to, like, kill an afternoon with. I'll send 4 people and see how that goes. Let's see, heavily armed gunmen attacked an armored truck. Several eyewitnesses heard an explosion and saw robbers carrying machine guns. Damn. What the hell's with the armed robberies today? But yeah, there's a lot of, like, sexism and all that kind of stuff. I literally sent the paddy wagon and SWAT. You don't need anybody else. You also have a beard with you. If you have beard, you don't need anything else. And we found automatic weapons. Sell to the mafia. I mean, Mafia assignment. I don't want to bring, okay. I'm writing it down. I'm writing it down. Mafia. Ignore. crime at 13:19. Okay. Wow, really? You're only giving me 250 for that? Damn. All right. Hopefully it's not too bad. Technically, the Mafia still likes us. All right, the armed truck is lying on its side, smoke raising from it. Nearby black Jeep with no plates, which robbers are loading with the money. Oh, thanks, Lols, boys. That helps, too. Let's see. Ram the Jeep with the patrol car. I don't know about the drop your weapons, you're surrounded. We could ram the patrol, or ram the Jeep with the patrol car. We could send a bullet through the Jeep's front wheel. I feel like we catch him by surprise and ram the Jeep with the patrol car. Do the badass thing. The robbers fire as they retreat down the alley and throw a grenade towards the cops. Hide behind the patrol car. It turned out to be a smoke grenade. Meanwhile, the criminals have jumped into the jumped out onto the road, jacked up old pickup truck, and they're trying to get away. Open fire on them. Nice. That worked out well. And we got money. Laundered the money to the Mafia. I don't like the fact that we have to sell money to the Mafia. That just sounds awkward. Jose Sugg called the station and muttered his sad story through streaming tears. I was just trying to get to know a pretty girl and gave her the coolest compliment in the world, but she just went crazy and beat me so badly she mangled me and ruined my perfect face. Holy shit. Alright. It probably wasn't the most awesome smooth comment ever. He probably said something offensive. Why is there so many things happening today? About 24 scientists who recently lost their jobs decided to wage a protest march at the city center. The participants marched peacefully along the side of the road. But then some religious fanatics came out and started throwing stones at them, tearing their clothes, and generally humiliating them. A massive brawl broke out and several people are already injured. Holy shit. He might actually be Prince Charming. I mean, you never know. Just save two people for whatever the hell goes on. The guy offered the girl a quickie and she merely slapped him across the face. I love those ones. Those are awesome. Let me see here. Oh, Addis Corp. Let's see. We've got assault. A call just came in from a secretary of therapist Alan Graham. She reports that Dr. Graham was attacked by a patient during an otherwise normal session. The patient pinned him to the floor and slapped him in the face. I'm afraid the doctor might have an asthma attack, he said, the frightened secretary. All right, proceed. Hey, how's the investigations going, by the way? Do I have anybody today? Oh, I do. Wow. Sweet. I can actually take out another investigation. Oh my gosh. You don't need more people. You have Beard and a paddy wagon. Beard and a paddy wagon! Alright, there we go. And abuse of emergency services. Once again, retiree Yang Hu. Complained to the police that local restaurant is preparing its dishes incorrectly. They don't advertise their portions and mix up the ingredients. We've warned her a dozen times that this isn't a police matter, but she keeps calling and bothering our personnel. Now, what is this? Jack Boyd, a common acquaintance, told me that you're a reasonable man and can be relied on for help. I need to load 4 luxury cars to the port, but to be frank, they're stolen. But fuck you. If anything, I should arrest that asshole. I would love a second option to be like, fuck you, I'm arresting you. Like, these are usually the you're doing something corrupt thing, and sometimes it's cool events. But otherwise, it'd be great for like it to be like, you know, go help him or go arrest him. That'd be amazing. I would love that. All right, what do we got here? An abduction. A passerby noticed a suspicious black van sitting in the van next to a little white girl. I'm afraid... Oh, a black man, not a black van. Sitting in a van next to a little white girl. I'm afraid to imagine what that monster has in store for the little angel. Fuck, I missed it. Fuck, I fucking went to it. Shit. Damn it. Dude, the racism is real. Now, granted, I feel it is my duty to respond to this only because if, like, I don't want a child abducted on my watch. So my presence will be there, but I don't believe this fucker. Abuse of the emergency services. Nice. Arrest that bitch. Calling us about freaking Chinese restaurants and not having the right portions and shit. Whoa, massive fight. Let's see. Some guy tried to sneak into the doctor's office without waiting for his turn. A few people who were waiting in line decided to punish the bastard and and a fight started up. Gosh, SWAT and the paddy wagon are getting some work today. Damn. I can send SWAT 4 times a day, so I'll do it. The man turns out to be the girl's adopted father. Fucking wow. See, now, in this case, in the false alarms, I would love to arrest that bitch who called in. And make up false charges to have her spend a night in jail. For being a racist bitch. I would love that. Get fucking racist. Oh my gosh. Alright, I've unfortunately, like, had this guy, like, stood up a bunch of times, so I will send some people, Jack. Some Hellraisers set fire to our warehouse, sending a couple of police to control the situation while we recover our property. Oh, no, Trizati, it's cool. I'm with you there. let's see. There are men and women fighting in a narrow hallway, and they're starting to pick a fight. Are starting to pick up chairs. Lower the chairs! No! Damn it! Beard's experience. Fuck, what is happening? This town is just going to shit. Seriously, though. Yeah, yeah, I think my 2-year streaming anniversary is going to be Saturday or Sunday. Shit, yeah, I should probably do something, shouldn't I? for that celebration of me streaming 2 years on Twitch. I mean, I tried to do every single day, so I mean, I did pretty well for myself. Oh yeah, Chizadi, nice. I don't know what SWAT stands for. I don't know. We should do something. But yeah, I've been on Twitch 2 years. Yeah, this coming like Saturday or Sunday. I don't know which day, unfortunately. Actually, I do have a hilarious story about when I started. If you weren't here when I did start, and actually there's a lot of you who have been here since the beginning, which is pretty fucking amazing. Thank you, guys. But holy shit. I started off in the basement of my house with a, like, Japanese privacy screen, like, with rice paper behind me. It was hot as balls. Well, it's hot as balls in my room now, so I guess that hasn't changed. But I was playing Morrowind, and it was so funny because I was literally testing the game, and the first person who ever followed me was a guy named Kingster. Even before my dad followed me, this guy named Kingster followed me as I was testing my stream. I hadn't even played the game. I was just saying, hey, is this working? And then someone followed. It was the most hilarious thing ever. It was like, this is going well. It was funny. You murder every living soul in Morrowind. That'd be a hell of a party. Oh, sausage, waffle, and tomato is what SWAT stands for. Excellent. SWAT and the flies. Yeah, I remember that time. Holy shit. Oh, man. Let's see. My dad occasionally will watch the stream. He usually has a long day at work, and he usually relaxes at night, so occasionally he'll stop by. But, you know, it's kind of a rare thing. He really likes Candy Crush, so he plays a lot of Candy Crush. And then, you know, takes a nap, because he's going to be like 60, I think this Sunday as well. I'll have to celebrate his birthday. Oh, yeah! Me and my dad played Gauntlet Dark Legacy. By the way, I just figured out how to start streaming GameCube/Wii games again. So that might be back on the menu eventually, but I'd save that for maybe an off time. To stream Candy Crush for him? my dad's so proud of his Candy Crush, too, because he's like, out of all the people I know, I'm the highest in level. I'm like, holy shit, Dad, you're the best. Alright, let's see here. That's right. What is this? The audience of the premiere, The Rules of the Game, was so outraged at the French film that they broke the chairs in the hall and other threatening fire in the cinema. The perplexed theater director locked himself in the office, then called the report in the incident. I can't imagine why my film has angered them. Yeah, I know, right? I know, that'd be cool. Yeah, my dad's birthday and stream anniversary. What do we got here? Explosion? Shit, I just literally sent like a lot of my people over there. Smoke is rising from an apartment building and the residents are running out in the street. Some are saying that suspicious foreigners live in the apartment that the explosion came from. How funny would it be if it was a microwave popcorn incident? I had a lot of those in college. Holy shit. You'd think people don't even know how to fucking use a microwave in college. Gosh. The worst is when you have a big test tomorrow, and someone burns popcorn in the microwave, and then, like, the fire alarm goes, and there was one time I was like, I'm just gonna fucking ignore it. But I can't, because you actually get in trouble and get a fine for trying to ignore the fire alarm. But yeah. And then you have to stand out in the cold. And your pajamas. It was awful. Alright, we'll wait till we have more frames. But seriously, people need to learn how to use the microwave, especially in college, because... No! Shit. Actually, fun fact. Oh, Rucksack of Joy, yeah, my Arcane Assassin Morrowind series is on YouTube, yeah. Oh gosh, friggin' A. So, I learned a cool thing. So, we can actually, instead of waiting for the next day, you can actually fire this guy, or declare him dead right now if you go into the personnel, and then immediately go into the labor market. Oh my gosh, Lulz Boys, that's awful. The apartment is filled with smoke and the walls are covered in soot. At the center of the room stands a man in a dirty white coat, and around him are scattered old pieces of scattered odd pieces of a complicated device. Seeing the police, the man begins to explain incoherently that he's almost finished his work for his elixir of youth and just needs a little more time. Oh yes, that sounds important. Do you need help, the help of the Freeburg police? Oh no, he escaped. Shit. Oh shit. Oh. Whoops. Whoops. Shit, we failed two things today, which is kind of unfortunate. Although I did respond to mostly everything. That kind of sucks, though. Ooh.
Mr. Boyd, Kevin Paulson is here. He wants to talk.
Kevin Paulson.
Hey, Slushy.
Tell him to fuck off. Jack Boyd, super cop.
Why the half a million, Jack? Why?
Lana, what happened?
Does this sum have some kind of special meaning?
Lana, I don't know who told you about the half million, but it's much more complicated than you think.
Oh, it's complicated, all right. It took me an hour to go over all the documents. There's even a few pictures and a lot of answers. Except for one thing. Why half a million?
What documents? How did you get them? What's in them?
I think you know very well what's in them, and the one who sent them is obviously a big fan of your criminal talents. He even has a cute name for you. Cupcake.
Remember when you told me you're always surrounded by old men? I'm the opposite. I'm surrounded by children. 9-year-old boys. From their first day of work, they gather in the smoking lounge telling jokes about what they'll do when they loot their first million. But it's more than just innocent jokes. It's quickly becoming a reality. They themselves are surprised how quickly everything happens. They buy their own houses, they buy a car, they get promoted. The first million is soon followed by a second, a third, a fifth. Like children, they have no idea what they're getting into. But I'm not like that, Lana. I'm not like them.
You're saying you're not like them because you're only stealing half a million?
I only meant
that... You know, Jack, I'm done worrying about people not taking me seriously. They'll know I mean business when my first act as public prosecutor is throwing the city's former police chief in prison.
Lana, you can't just read over some papers like this and... I told you not to let him in!
I'm sorry, Mr. Boyd. I tried to stop him, but you...
Lana, we need to talk.
Oh, shit.
Jack, you're so amazingly patient with people. After all the confusion over the past months, all the humiliations, it's really quite admirable. I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. I gotta admit, I'm not nearly so patient.
Send someone in here, now!
Can we punch this douche in the face?
When I take your place, I'll have a lot of opportunities. For example, I could arrest you. You know it wouldn't be hard to find a reason. You obviously don't want that, right? I don't want that either. Given your reputation, arresting you would make me very unpopular. And if we both don't want that, let's find a way out. My suggestion is you retire tomorrow, and I promise I'll let you leave in peace. I swear, Jack, if you...
Mr. Boyd, there's a call on line 2. Mr. Boyd, you really have to take this call.
Boyd!
Jack, it's me.
Laura, I...
Jack, I don't know what you wanted to say to me, but please, just say it. Jack, I'm hanging up the phone.
Laura, you... Oh, my God. Laura. Hey, you remember years ago? So many years I've lost track, but do you remember when Dylan was down with the chicken pox and he couldn't sleep? We kept him occupied until he passed out, and then we went downstairs, sat on the floor, opened a bottle of wine. Who could blame us? Well, we sat on the floor and opened our bills and joked about how poor we were. Remember? And then I jokingly asked if I'd be your hero if I made $1 million. And you sat there lost in thought like you needed to seriously think about the answer. You were quiet for a while, and then you laughed and said that I'd be your hero even if I only made half a million. Do you remember, Laura?
Jack,
do you remember?
Honestly, Jack, no, I don't remember.
You don't remember? But that
was... Jack, you've been chasing me down for so long to talk with me. For this? That's all you wanted to tell me?
How can you not remember? It's important, Laura. It's important.
Goodbye, Jack.
Fuck your phone.
Mr. Boyd, are you all right?
Uh-oh. Don't let there be another firm of pills. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. What is happening? It's Stradivarius, Jake. Some heavy shit just went down. Oh, yeah. This is nuts.
Mr. Boyd?
Oh, shit. Oh my gosh! Okay, so... Holy shit. For those of you who are just joining me now, this game is about managing a police station. You are basically playing a police officer, and he's got a lot of stuff going on in the background. So... How do I explain what just happened there? Holy shit. So, basically, Lana, who's going to be the next, big prosecutor, basically found out that we've been doing shitty shit on the side, and she figured out that we're going to basically steal, like, $500,000, and she hates us now, so we lost, you know, favor with her. Then the guy who's going to take our job threatened that he would arrest us unless we retired today. And then we called our wife, and she doesn't remember, like, the heartfelt moments of whatever Jack was holding on to. Holy crap. Yeah, we screwed up. We screwed up bad. I mean, I could have told Jack to stop chasing his wife, you know, a few hundred days ago, but that's just me. Also not leaving a paper trail. So here's Dr. Boyd. Now, the last time this weird stuff happened, we went into a coma, after being struck by a pipe, while trying to meet our ex-wife. So this must be another little you're in a coma mini game, which means we ended at like day 105. So we might actually be closer to the end than we think, actually. So, there's only one player mode or single player mode, because we're all by ourselves. Now, last time, it didn't give me any explanation. Oh, I got it. I know how it works now, I think. Maybe? How does this game work? I've never played this. Shit. I thought it was like Tetris. Apparently it's not like Tetris at all. Is it Tetris? Yeah, it looks like Dr. Mario. And I have not played Dr. Mario, so I have no idea what I'm doing at all. In fact, I'm pretty sure I screwed myself. Ooh, I did something. Ooh, okay. All right. We're getting somewhere? Nice. Okay. All right. Looks like I have to do a four in a row. Okay. Ooh, I messed up there. It's not going to help me out. Shit. By the way, I'm not good at Tetris, nor have I played, like, Dr. Mario, so I have no fucking idea what I'm doing, by the way. Alright, I have to get the yellows out of the way. Can I do, like, a square? Ooh, I can't do a square. Okay, got rid of that. Good. Nice. Nice. Okay. Gosh. No! Damn it. Nice. Can I, like, stick... That just sounds weird. Ha! Ah, I was able to stick it in. I need to pile some stuff on the other side here. Yeah, see, I don't even know how to win. Oh, yeah? Yeah, I have no idea how to play this game. I'm pretty sure I'm just screwing myself over royally. Shit. Okay. Ooh, got him. Okay, so they count as... Okay, all right. I may start to understand what the hell I'm doing here. Okay. Okay, so I have to get rid of that red. So let's make a line of red. I have to get rid of that too. Alright, we have to get rid of the yellow. Alright, the red's kind of screwed right now. Blue's also kind of screwed, but I might be able to do this. Take that out. Alright, yellow. Ah, shit, I screwed myself over again. Okay. Shit out of the way. Screwed myself over again with red. I have to get rid of this blue. Ooh, nice. Okay, now I just have to get some red in there. I'm just gonna put that to the side. Let's try to finish off some yellows. I'm wondering if we could maybe do this. Okay, cool. Starting to get a hang of this. Yeah, I did it! Oh, shit. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is when you have to fail, because holy shit, I was not prepared for this. Well, that worked.
Yes, you caught me again. And again, I promise this is the last time. And now you say again that I've said it all before, but I'm...
Jack Boyd is awake.
Jack Boyd? He opened his eyes? He can talk?
Talking, yes. More like yelling, trying to escape from his room, brawling with the nurses.
Good heavens. He's a tough son of a bitch.
Day 155. Yeah, it's like Dr. Morrow, yeah.
Jack! Lord, were you already discharged from the hospital? I thought you might be down a couple of days, or even...
Yeah! Punch that douche in the face!
Emma, get me the mayor. Emma, please call the mayor of Freeburg, Stuart Rogers.
Three-one-one-four. Connect. It's urgent.
We got
this
our
is
old
Jack
back.
Boyd.
Jack, you've got to take better care of yourself. How's your...
I'm Freeburg's police chief. I came to work. Stop trying to get in my way.
Yeah, fuck you, Rogers.
Someone causing you trouble? We just wanted to make sure somebody was holding down the fort while you, while you were recovering. But don't
later,
worry
dude.
About a thing. I'll take care of everything tomorrow morning. You won't be running into Paulson again.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. I'm glad we understand each other. Tell Martin Stett to call me.
What? You don't know? Lieutenant Stett went missing about 2 weeks ago.
Oh, shit. That was our right-hand man, man. We don't have our fancy digs anymore. Alright, what do we got? Elementary school breaks its only computer. Snowfall paralyzes downtown traffic. And dinosaur skull found in the city dump. Now, it's... literally been... Gosh, it must have been around 50 days we were in a coma. But everybody still fucking likes us, so there we go. Alright, well shit. That's a hell of a thing. So, I guess... And listen, there's like crows in the background. That's disturbing. I know, yeah, we're done. I assume that we're done on day 180, so we only have 30 days to go. I think Jack was in a coma around 50 days. Because it was around 100 when I started the stream, or like 101, and we went through maybe like 4 or 5 days. So it was about 50-ish, yeah. Yeah, I mean, we also had a coma before, so it seems like it's 180, but in reality, we're in a coma for 70 to 100-ish days. I'm not exactly sure, I haven't actually counted the first one. But yeah, so we're doing... alright, despite Lana basically hating us because she learned about us wanting half a million. Laura, our ex-wife, basically cutting all ties because we basically obsessed over her. And yeah, looks like we're back in action, but we're not as fresh as we used to be. So we'll have to see what happens next time. But yeah, so I'll be switching over to Morrowind. Very excited for Morrowind as well, but yeah, so hopefully you guys enjoyed today. We'll be back with some, more This Is the Police tomorrow, as well as more Morrowind. But stay tuned for some more Morrowind, just as soon as I switch the title. I'll just put it on the title screen, and ready to go. So be back in a bit!